feel like the whole team grew up a lot because, you know, this is a real dogfight. It's a war. You know, it was a hard, difficult game. But I feel like through all the disappointment, I think the team grew a lot.
Now you guys had a chance still to win the ball game. It has to hurt. I mean, you guys close to getting over that hump, being a ranked opponent. I mean, really, though, what's the feeling when the clock struck zero, when you saw that interception, or that fumble, I'm sorry.
You know, real disappointed and real disappointed when you know you can win the game and you have an opportunity to win the game right there in front of your hands and it just slips away like that. But, you know, I always stay positive and look to the next week.
What does this team do, though, you know, mentally now, preparing for the rest of the season and maybe knowing SEC is out of the picture, but we still can win some ball games?
Well, it's a good thing that we have an open date coming up, that bye week, so we can, you know, go through all the mistakes that we made this game, correct those, give our body a little bit of rest, and, you know, come back the next game with, you know, just more power than we came with this game.
How did you guys just battle back, though? I know the defense obviously helped a lot, but offensively you guys stayed in there, and when, you know, you didn't see that against Florida, and you didn't, you know? It seemed like, oh, this is going to be another long night.
Yeah, you know, I mean, we came into this game with a lot of confidence, and, you know, we felt like, you know, we were a better team than them, and, you know, things just didn't go our way. But, you know, we had confidence throughout the whole game that we could beat them.
You talk about Tyler. Do you feel that he was, you know, communicating well with you guys today? I don't know, maybe some people say his body language wasn't there and seemed like he didn't really care, but then, you know, he still stayed in there too and fought back.
Yeah, Tyler was 100% in the game the whole time. He made his calls. You know, he made mistakes just like everybody else on the field, and, you know, we're going to continue to roll with him.
Who's like really talking though, like after, you know, like maybe a 3-and-out and all that stuff? And who's the guy talking and getting you guys ready to get back on the field?
Tyler, along with the coaches, and, you know, it's more of a team thing. Everybody's motivating each other, and, you know, everybody's into it.
What did you guys say in the last drive that you had, when you had the opportunity, not the last like 15 seconds, but the play before when he fumbled?
Let's do it. Keep our heads up. Let's go.
Michael, just how disastrous kind of were those three turnovers on three consecutive drives in the game?
Yeah, you know, those speak for itself. I mean, they're not good.
Well, what happened on some of those? It seems like the protection breakdown and make Tyler hurry. I guess what happened?
Yeah, I don't know. I'm running my route, so I can't see none of that.
What do you think has to happen to pull out some of those tough SEC games like this when it's tight late in the game?
You know, we got to just continue to fight. Fight on, fight back. You know, if one thing would have changed with this game, you know, we'd have won it. So, I mean, we just got to continue to do what we're doing and not, you know, not turn to any other things and just continue to fight, you know, when we're down or when we're up. Just continue to stay in the flow.
Do you guys leave with any more confidence, just knowing that you guys were there for four quarters? I mean, you had almost three opportunities to even the score up.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, number five team in the country, and we're right there toe-to-toe, you know, 90% of the game. So, you know, that's got to give us confidence.
And even more so, again, you know, the difference between this game and the Florida game. Do you guys kind of sense a difference, or was there a difference in the locker room and on the sidelines and stuff?
Yeah, we were coming into this game with a lot of confidence, and, you know, especially coming in a halftime tie game, you know, we were ready. We were ready to battle.
Does it affect your confidence when you lose in a tie game like this?
No, I don't think so, because, you know, it's just it's a matter of mistakes. We're going to go back and correct those mistakes, and we're going to be sick looking at the mistakes and seeing all the bad stuff that we did, but we can continue to improve on those and continue to fight back.
Mike, are you seeing the production in the running game affect the passing side of the offense now after not having as much last year?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you know, having Cordero out there, having Justin, having so many guys out there that the defense has to look at, you know, it opens a lot of opportunities for myself, and it also opens opportunities for them.
The running game helping you guys too, though? Is it keeping some safeties,
yeah,
you know, on their heels maybe?
Yeah, definitely. You know, the O-line is blocking really well right now, opening up holes. Rajon's getting through them. And, you know, the play fakes, they go for the play fakes. So, you know, that'll help you.
Two more for Michael, guys.
Michael, how much was Tyler Bray having to check down in his progressions, and then how much was that open to you guys in those check downs?
I mean, there was times where he had to check down because, you know, you got guys like, you know, Jarvis coming off the edge, and, you know, you got a lot of rushes, and Tyler's trying to move around in the pocket. But, you know, overall, he was really trying to read those progressions out, and it was just hard with the pressure.
There was a lot of pressure, I guess, on you guys or whatever today. The coach said you leave here a better football team. Do you believe that? Where do you guys go from here?
Yeah, definitely. You know, number five team in the country coming in at halftime, tie game, you know, battling out till the end of the fourth quarter. I mean, we're right there. We just got to keep our confidence and continue. continue to believe, and I feel like we're going to make it over the hump, and we'll be all right.
You feel like you showed today that this program is definitely moving in the right direction under Coach Dooley?
Yeah, definitely. I feel like, you know, Coach Dooley is the way to go, and he's teaching us the right way. And I feel like, you know, just adversity is going to hit you at all times. We just got to continue to fight on.
Michael, you guys are fighting from behind, but you had some opportunities, especially right after the half when you were tied or ahead. Just couldn't quite. Is there a different mindset for the team when you're trailing? What do you think?
You know, we didn't want to lose this game. We were just coming in, and we were just trying to fight as hard as we could. And unfortunately, things didn't go our way. But you know, we kept our chin up, and we were just trying to fight.
Last question.
Did you learn a lot about your quarterback, Coach Oaks? He saw some things on his journey.
Yeah, definitely. I learned a lot about the whole team. You know, we can fight toe to toe with a number 5 team in the country. And you know, I feel like, you know, we're a really good team.
Thank you.